Be the first to acquire 7 towns. Really? I thought I have... Ooh, we're very close to making that. Maybe it's referring to towns you actually own as opposed to, vassals or something. Yeah, we got vassals earlier, I suppose. I mean, there's gotta be another, empire quest we can get. Be the first to player with cities of 5 different races. Be the first player with 8 cities of the same race. What else? All-knowing? Be the first to research all skills. You receive 2 new specializations chosen at random. Interesting. Be the first to construct an arcane forge item. An arcane forge building or something, yeah. So I think we should be able to do that, actually. Let's try it. I'm surprised no one else has done it, so let's do it right here. I don't think this is their throne city, so, but yeah, at least we know exactly how to get there, just in case we want to declare war later. Now, can the nymphs swim? No, they can't swim. And they will never gain, the ability to actually swim, so, yeah. Not very useful. But hey, we have a floating army now. If we can train the hero, of course. Okay, so you are the most important now, baby shock serpent. Actually, we should probably try awakening him too. Oh, but we can't do it anymore. Oops. You can teleport, so we have nothing to worry about for there. Actually, let's move you this way. They decided not to move. You can always use Holy Cure later on. So for now, I'm just gonna shoot. Oh, this guy has a shield. Come on. When are they gonna move? Ouch. Are you kidding me? We just lost a hero? What? Wow. Wow, that was ridiculous. I thought heroes were a bit stronger than that. So yeah, unfortunately we lost a hero apparently, and yeah, they just sort of blitzed him and he was gone. Ugh, that was just disgusting. Hopefully he comes back to life. I don't know, does your heroes have resurgence? Okay, so he has resurgence. Thank goodness. And we gained the mature shock serpent. Looks pretty terrifying. Unfortunately they don't have a ranged attack. Yeah. So it's a melee thing and we kind of have to take care of them. Anyway, so we have two snakes here. You know what, we'll keep you there just to heal up a little bit. Alright, so you both have some decent cavalry going on. You will get this. There's a Draconian Flamer, which I'm very tempted to grab as well. Ice Scaper versus Harpoon Thrower, which one is more useful here? Thinking we take the Harpoon Thrower. Right, so I have a decent army there. Oh, so how many do we have? Alright, so this is a scouting army here. Where do we want to put them? I think we'll put them to defend that area. Just leave them there for now. Do I want to keep these guys closer to the rest of my empire, just in case the Necromancer leader decides to attack? Something to be said there. What is this? More Frostlings. Okay. Yeah, just keep holding. Baluar Snowmane is lighting their Unity Beacon in Yelasser in 3 turns. Boy, he really is, he's really going the distance, isn't he? We're gonna take Cleanse the Land. That's the spell that I was talking about. Hang on, let me just, yeah, show you there. Target hexes are instantly converted to temperate terrain. Corrupted springs and corrupted farms in the area. Of effect will be cleansed of corruption. So this is actually also useful against the when dealing with a Necromancer, yeah, because eventually we're gonna sort of invade their lands and such. So it would be nice to get that stuff going. And we have enough gold to actually get some research, so let's do that. Get a little observatory to improve our territory as well. Yeah, all of a sudden, it looks like, see here, the cities are very close to each other, so that kind of... it kind of restricts their growth a little bit, see? Requires a lot of planning, you might say. Now, actually, now that we have this worker here, I'm thinking we could establish an outpost here. We can gain some income. Yeah. If we build the outpost here, it will get this and that and the dungeon. But of course, we have to explore it first before we get the bonuses from it. Yeah, Builder's Hall. Actually, not a Builder's Hall. Let's take the Shrine instead. Could use some mana. So what am I gonna do with these guys? I guess we can just leave them there, prepare for the eventual war with the Necromancer. I kinda wanna stop this guy from lightning the beacon or whatever he's doing, but looks like that's gonna take a while. You know, it would be very difficult to actually get over there and destroy him, so it looks like we just have to compete. And I don't know what to do with these. We've done a good deal of scouting. Maybe we should try and find some other leaders nearby. Now I think we should be able to kill them off just fine auto combat, right? Yes, we did. So how much more until you gain experience here? Let's see. Oh, you're gonna take a long time. Oh dear. Actually, you got a new weapon, I think, right? No. They would have been able to freeze us, but it didn't work. Anyway. We do have two spiders there that we want to train. And another one here. So here's the plan. I'm actually going to entangle this guy. Yeah. Actually, that may be dangerous. Let's just move back a little bit. Oh, he can still hit us. Okay. Very well. Yeah, kill it. Awaken the animals. This is an ice scaper, but doesn't look too terrible, I suppose. So we're just gonna put him there. Awaken spirit. Now this one actually is an expert, so maybe we should have trained this guy instead. You know what? It's fine. Yeah, very hard to resist. The spider queens have a much higher success rate for the webs. See? Ooh, you still didn't gain experience? Okay, you did, but you didn't kill it. So, yeah, the target is gonna be this one. Although, actually, I could train on that one instead. So now he's a veteran. Because we don't need you. So now we have two Dread Spider Queens. Perfect. Now we have a bunch of them. So yeah, where do we want to go next? At this point, I think this area is like a very vast empty land, and it's great for colonization, but it's a bit too far for our empire. So yeah, we may have to choose a place. Actually, we didn't explore this, so let's go ahead and explore it now. Yeah, so once we explore this, then if we want to build a city, this would be a great place for it, actually. Right here. Could be Frostling, could be Halfling, whatever we want. Actually, probably Halfling is better at this point. You guys still have that spell cast on you, a Halfling city. You're the only Halfling city we have. All the others are, yeah, basically towns, but they will become cities soon, though. We have a Frostling city there. Yeah, we have multiple Frostling cities, actually. Which makes me think. Hang on, let me double check. Our governance, what's going on here? We're making 12 governance points for Halflings. We're making 17 with the Frostlings, and we're about to gain another city on them. So I think, yeah, it's time to build another Halfling city, I think. Let's go with... Oh, we don't have enough gold. Never mind. Yeah, once we have enough gold, we'll get that going. In the meantime, I think I'm going to train this guy. Now let's go pick on these a little bit. Again, there's something to be said about going for the seals victory. Shall we try this? I actually don't know how this exactly works. Like, it says here, gives +1 charge per turn to the occupying player. Occasionally spawns units to defend itself. Does that mean that even while we're occupying it, it will continue spawning random units? Like, that sounds rough. That sounds like something I don't want to deal with for too long. But yeah, you know what? I think we can throw some of these scouting armies at this, at these seal locations, and that might work. Because there's really nothing else we can do with them, so I guess makes sense, right? So yeah, we already have a seal here. It's within our territory. We might as well send, like, we have three armies here. They should be enough to destroy those elementals, and then we can just put some army on them and, yeah, enjoy the countdown. No, hang on, there's someone there. Mammoth, yeah. So from now on, every time one of our vassals gives us like a free unit or something, we will just send it here, try and control these seals as much as possible. I know it's not very wise going for multiple victories, but hey, why not? I mean, we gotta have some kind of contingency plan, you know? Just in case something goes wrong. What do you got? Quell the rebellion. Give me a halfling jester. Whatever, we'll take it. Even though we're very far away. Alright, so we let them run. I think these guys can make it around towards the seal over there. Yeah, I guess they can. They can. Good. So, all right. So we're gonna send our best soldiers inside. Who's it gonna be? This one's an expert, you know what, we're gonna send you guys. Should be simple. Try to web this guy. Oh really? He resisted? Good. Really? You guys are resisting way too many of my webs. We want the spider to gain a level, so it's getting close. Actually, hang on. Awaken this. Oh, he's no longer entangled. Okay. Jewel of Forgotten Revival, plus 12 regeneration. Oh my. So who's gonna get this? Yeah, we'll give it to our leader. Where is she, by the way? Okay, freeze water. would be useful. I mean, we're not dealing with any roaming armies in the water yet, but this could be nice. You know what? I'll take it. And later on, we're going to start cleansing this area, I think. Is there a way for us to do it now? Cleanse the land. Oh, we have to cast it first? Okay. Mistdale. That's fine by me. Right, so I remember I was saying just now we were saving some money for something. What was that for? Oh yeah, settler, I think. Halfling settler? Yeah. All of a sudden, we have no money. Should probably build a road down there. Yeah. Towards the seal. Right this way. Do we want to all gang up on the same seal location? Race governance leveled up, nice. Well, I don't want to actually want to cast it here, but you know what? It's fine. Alright, so we have champion. Temples in Frostling cities will now produce an additional 10 mana, which I kind of like. All Frostling Mammoth Riders are cheaper. And take an additional +2 melee damage. Huh. Hang on. Now I think I wanna just check. How many Mammoth Riders do we have? I think we have only two. We don't have too many. Where are they anyway? They were all here somewhere. Yeah, there they are. Okay, we have three Mammoth Riders. And I don't think we're gonna build too many of them. However, the +10 mana in temples is really good. So I kind of like that. Right now we only have one temple, but if we build more of these, because we're going to be summoning a bunch of units, actually. Baby Kraken! Yes, gimme. This is more of a fun unit. I mean, it's not going to be very useful to our overall strategy, but it's just something fun to have, you know? Actually, come to think of it, how many... Yeah, I just want to see, it has 9 per turn, so it's not too expensive in terms of mana. We can spam these. We could build like a bunch of them and just send them out to clear the waters here, I suppose. If we don't want to build a navy, we might as well do that, right? Hang on, this is Baluar. Oh yeah, this is our ally. I was in a bit of a panic for a second there, like, oh my god, this guy has an army. Yeah, these are not too powerful, actually. Just they're basically scouts. And he has a settler for some reason. I'm not sure what he's doing here. This area is mine, buddy. I wonder, maybe we should go with an alliance with this guy. So he's currently quite happy. Let's negotiate. Let's maybe start an alliance or something. Yeah, so we sent the proposal. We now just wait for his reply. Yeah, let's grab a laboratory. Why not? And for now, we're just going to play cool. Alright, so we can build a Unity Beacon. If we save up like 1,200 gold, we will be able to build this thing. And, so where am I going to build it? 14 turns here. Also 14 turns here. So we need a lot of production to get this thing, which we don't have right now. I mean, if this eventually becomes part of my territory, it might give us plus 5 production. Again, it's not too much. Which one of these cities is the most productive we have? 20 turns here for the Unity Beacons. A lot of turns. So I guess the main advantage we have over Baluar is the fact that we focused on two races at the same time. So if we, like, if we manage to become super friendly with the halflings real quick, we're actually ahead of him in that regard. So yeah, at this point we're just gonna save money. Forget the seals, forget all that bullshit, we're just gonna hold out. We're gonna turtle up in this area. We have a nice halfling city here, very well protected. I think it's a good candidate for the Unity Beacon. Or even this one. Although eventually it might get attacked by the Necromancer down there, so I'm thinking, yeah, this one is the best probably. It has a lot of production as well, look at that. Tons of production. For a halfling city. In fact, we can prepare. We could start building siege workshops and stuff like that. In fact, actually, forget this. You know what? But the research is important. Whatever. I mean, while we are here, we might as well take the seals, right? Just get them out of the way. Which one of you guys has the most expendable units? I think this is expendable. This one, not so much. Floating army is useful for defense, so I'm thinking, you know what? All of you, just gang up on them. Alright, this is going to be a very tough fight, so let's do this.